Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 2. Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. What is this guy? I had an idea. Is this him? No, that's not him. We keep getting killed. Oh, I lost 11 current radiation level. Zero. Okay, cool. We keep getting killed by the... I believe it's the Enclave. But I have an idea. I was gonna reload a previous save, but I had an idea to get rid of, at least for now, this Lenny, this ghoul. Because that's one of the previous... That's him. It takes him a while to keep up, I guess. What you did want me to do? As one of the previous, well, the last question, either involves, you know, this is my uncle, but I don't like ghouls or something like that, or we have no idea who this guy is, so I'll try this, see if it works. I need you to wait here until I come back. Oh, okay. Oh, well, wait right here until you get back. Give me a chance to rest that aching joints. Alright. That's it for now. Okay. So maybe we can do it like this. Because I do like to try to remain as true to the playthrough as possible. If that makes any sense. But, you know, obviously if we reach a point where we can't, like a complete impasse, then we can't continue. Okay, here we go. Oh! Okay, I believe you. Fan out, man. Search the area. We gotta find this person. Ta-da. You've just entered a large plane just outside of Gecko. There are people here wearing some high-tech armor. Vertebrate. Nothing out of the ordinary. ...150 hit points, Pancor jackhammer, with 12-gauge shotgun shells. This one has a PPK-12 Gauss pistol, with 12 out of 12 shots of 2mm EC. That's nothing, Myron. Pancor jackhammer. You get no response from the guard. Okay, let's not press it. We just did. Get the hell out of here! Now, I wonder if they're gonna... I wanna enter. What do we need to check with? Let's go from the courtyard. Because, we have a few people to check up on. I think they're both inside. Solve the Gecko power plant. I haven't exactly done that. There was something we had to do. I know that. It's just not listed here. I can get into the city. Probably. What time is it? That's in the morning. Good. Let's check with the customs guy. And that closed the door. Love when that happens. Nothing new there. Oh wait, talk to him. Oh. Damn it, I hate that. So... Vic! Maybe a different strategy, such as you taking this stuff. Yeah, I want that cheesy poofs. I think that might be it. Love this theme. Okay. Hell yeah, that's a good trade. I just gave you that stuff for nothing. Yeah, he doesn't say that, but... Okay, now, here you go. It's a good thing they only check me for some stupid reason. She wants more beer and stuff, and you have to get it. We needed something from amenities, didn't we? Oh right, we wanted to see if we could get a super tool, I believe it is. Well, I'm just looking at my stuff. That's a tool, regular tool. Let's check in here because this is Vic's daughter. She might talk to us now. She may have a tool for us. Valerie. You won't believe this. Not less than a day after you gave me those tools, that super toolkit I ordered arrives. But not just one. They send me 5. What the hell is wrong with the ordering office? Could you part with one of those toolkits? Why not? What am I going to do with 5? Take it. I swear that I'm going to beat the living tar out of the list office for this. For free? Alright. Thanks. Say some questions. Yeah, what's the deal with you and your father? Nothing worth mentioning. He came here 20 years ago on one of his caravan trips, knocked up Mom and left. Until he stopped by, I haven't seen him in about 5 years. No loss. Sounds like you and him have some things to work out. No, we don't. We've said all we need to say a long time ago. You sure? Yes, I'm sure. Well, except for the fact that I think he should lose some weight. He's got quite a spare tire going, and he should stop wandering all around the way selling junk to tribals. That's pretty much it. Oh, so she does like, care about him in a way. Look, he was in a mess of trouble with slavers, and he's trying to make up for lost time now. But you're right, he could stand to lose some weight. Heh heh. You've got a sarcastic edge. I like that. As far as old dad, well, I'll try and be a little more civil. For a while, anyway. Make sure he stays out of trouble, alright? I'll do my best. Something else I wanted to ask you. Yeah, what? Can you repair anything of mine? Well, maybe. Let's see what you got. Show me your pistols. Desert Eagle, I have an expanded magazine for $1,000. Yeah. Alright, just the Desert Eagle, apparently. We've got in stock. Look, I don't have anything in stock. This isn't a store. Most of the stuff I fix here ends up in the amenities office. It's out the door and to your left. Alright, alright, goodbye. I'm overloaded! How heavy is this kit? Holy crap. Super toolkit. An impressive tool set made by Snap-Off. It weighs 10 pounds. How much overweight are we? Only by 2 pounds. Oh, Vic! He needs to work out. Carry some more stuff for me. You can even have the cheesy poofs, just don't eat them. Oh, I need to read those books. Sorry, that's too much to carry. Well, I'm guessing I can walk though. Vic is overloaded. I didn't realize you could overload them. I thought they just wouldn't take it. I can't even take it now. Because I want to give it to Sulik then. You still overweight? Yes. Sulik! Where are you? You still in there or what? Where the hell is Sulik? Alright, let's zone. So I'm aware of this. Sulik is missing. So if I zone through... Yes, he's... Oh my god, it's like relentlessly telling me this. Sulik, my man! Need your help.
What you be needing?
Take that, and that, and that, and that, and that, and that. Now I can take the hammer back. Now see if I can give the hammer to Sulik as well.
What you be needing?
I've been needing you take this hammer. There you go. Sulik's not overloaded. Good to hear. I should sell some of that stuff anyway. I don't know why I thought she might say something interesting. Oh. Let me see if this lady has anything to say now. You see, first says in Lynette, she looks preoccupied.
Yes. What is it I can help you with?
About the Gecko power plant.
Have you resolved the situation?
I found out all they need to get their plant running clean is a hydroelectric magnetosphere regulator.
So you haven't taken care of the problem?
They're not gonna like this, but it's the truth. As I understand it, you have the part here in Vault City to fix their plant.
What if we do? That is only a temporary solution. Please fix the problem, not their power plant. Am I making myself clear?
Not sure if I should push this. So who would sell this part? Let me guess. If they did sell the part, I wouldn't be able to afford it. Crystal, I'll be back later. Oh well. Proconsul Gregory is supposedly more reasonable? Don't I remember hearing? Okay, well, we can't. Well, maybe it's this guy. McClure. Right, right. I can so get there. It's a matter of pathing. I think you might have a part that could fix Gecko's power plant. What do you mean? If I had a hydroelectric magnetosphere regulator, I could make their plant run clean. That's an acceptable solution. Stopping the radiation poisoning is all I care about. Am I worried about this? I guess so. I'm worried that Lynette will withhold my citizenship if I fix the plant. If you fix their plant, I'll give you citizenship, and there's not a damn thing she can do about it. Excellent. Where can I get the part? Go see Randall, the chief amenities officer. He should have the part in stock. Okay, chief amenities, Randall. There's one other thing. You might find this economic data disk interesting. I'm sorry? An economic data disk? What do you mean? It's an economic data disk that shows the amount of energy that Gecko's atomic power plant produced before the war and could produce again. I see. So what does this have to do with me? Well, as I understand it, Vault City's power generator can only support so many people. In fact, it's already nearing its limit. I'm not going to ask you how you came by that information, but if it were true, what are you proposing? Once the Gecko's power plant is fixed, the disk indicates it's possible it could produce enough energy for Vault City too. It looks like the reactor would need to be optimized first, though. Are you suggesting we seize Gecko and take their power plant? I will not list. No, no. If Gecko could receive the optimization data for their plant, I'm betting they would be willing to trade their excess power for medical assistance. As far as medical assistance goes, I'm not unsympathetic to the plight of the ghouls. They have certainly suffered enough, but how could we optimize their plant? I don't know. Maybe there's someone I can talk to once the plant is repaired. I have no objections to your proposal. If you can find some means of optimizing the plant, let me know. Alright, I'll go get that part from Randall and see about repairing the reactor first. I'll keep the economic disk and study it some more. Perhaps I can persuade the council to enter negotiations with Gecko to trade for their power. The data disk would be a strong argument in and of itself. I appreciate it. Thanks. I want to read the disk, though. Okay, we got 750 experience. We gave the economic data disk to McClure. Is there anything past us? Alright. Okay, just needed a quick drink. Yeah, so there was somebody in. What do you call it? Requisitions. We need to talk to Randall. Not requisitions, amenities. Looking for. Didn't I want to talk to one of these people? Not sure. Alright. Probably don't need to talk to these people. Just checking in anyway. Back again? You lost, or do you need something? Yeah, there's no one else. Everyone's... Alright. Okay, so the main amenities office, I'm guessing. Randall, I presume? Hey there, welcome back. Anything I can do for you? Councilor McClure said you'd have a hydroelectric magnetosphere regulator in stock that I could have. Yeah, he said you'd be stopping by. Andrea King, right? Wait 1 minute, I'll go get you the hydroelectric magneto, the high mag. Alright. Okay, here you go, one high mag. Kinda looks like a lava lamp, doesn't it? Oh, don't drop it. It's pretty fragile. Maybe we shouldn't reveal to him that we're going to the gecko plant. I don't know how he feels about that. What else do you have in stock? He's not gonna do transactions. Yeah, I've been through a lot of that. Alright. There it is. Does sort of look like a hydro. Another lava lamp. Hydroelectric part. Another 10-pound thing. Alright. So now we gotta work with this crap and deal with this. Okie-dokie. Drop and give me 20. Back to Gecko, then. This guy's gonna stop us again. No, good. Oh, cool. I like that. It actually looks like a photo. Settlement. I guess you can come with us again. I wasn't sure you'd come back. Well, here I am. This time, maybe let's not piss off the Enclave. Oh. Hooray for superior pathing. This time, anyway. Nice part you got there. Just what we need. Glad you like it. Want to install it? I'd like to help you out, but I wouldn't know how to install something like that. I mostly just watch the gauges here. Try Festus. He's the resident parts genius. Just ask him. Festus is out the way you came in. He's in the control room. Can't miss him. He's a smelly, whiny one tottering about underneath that huge ego. He should be able to help you. Talk to Festus about installing that part yet? Is there any other way? Well, if you could control the maintenance robot, it might be able to install it. Or you could just walk in there and install it yourself. Install it myself? Heh, I wouldn't advise that smoothie. You'd fry into a crisp. Me, I like the warmth, but I wouldn't recommend it for you. Quite a bit of heat and radiation in there. That's why the smoothies that built this place included a maintenance bot. They didn't want to fry either, so they included a robot. It was designed to perform maintenance tasks by remote control from that terminal over there. Alright. I will ask Festus, though. I thought this was Festus. Okay, I'm blocked. What brings you to this part of my atomic reactor? Well, I have a part that you can use to fix the reactor. You have a spare hydroelectric magnetosphere regulator on you? You actually know what that is? Surprised? Never doubt my knowledge about atomic power plants. I know everything there is to know about them. So I've heard. Well, since you know what it is, you must know how to install it. I guess he can't put his money where his mouth is. Of course I do. Well, it's just plain simple for someone of my experience and talent. I was weaned on magnetosphere regulators as a pup, you know. That's great. Could you install it for me? Well, I guess I could install it. I'm certainly the one that can install it right. Installing a hydroelectric magnetosphere regulator is pretty tricky. Here's the regulator. I knew I could count on you. Okay, I'm here, but I'm still not sure that this isn't the right part. Or that it's not a trap, somehow. You know, I'm much too valuable to waste. Maybe I should just let someone else do this. Later. Much later. It needs to be done now, and you're the only person that can do it right. Come on, all of Gecko depends on you. Okay, that's got it. Hey, I did it. I really am that good. Actually getting better. Told you I wouldn't let you down, boss. Oh dear, I've actually learned something from this. Whoa! So he really could do it? I thought he was just BSing the whole time. Festus leaves and then comes back. He's still carrying the part. Festus leaves and then comes back. He looks very pleased about something. Gone up a level. Vic has gained some abilities. Lenny as well. You've gained 4,200 experience points and gained 50 karma. Truly? The reactor's running pretty good now, alright? Could still do with a tiny bit of a tune-up, maybe, but I'd say it's a pretty good job all the same. More work? What do you mean? I mean that the reactor's running now, but it sure could run better. I mean better by a long country mile, but if we just had a smudge more data, you could get the optimization data. We'd be cooking with gas. Well, you know what I mean. Optimization data. Where would I get that? Okay, that's the second part, optimizing the reactor. Well, you could probably get the information from the Vault City Central Computer. Well, let me see what I can do. I bet a clever one like you could just sneak in there and use a holodisk with the reactor performance information on the Central Computer, then sneak the disk right back here. That'd do it. I'd do it myself, but I'm much too valuable here to leave, even for a moment. Well, I would hate to leave a job only half done. So he's going to grant me citizenship, and then I can get in there and get what I need to, right? McClure? I'm not even going to bother with, what's her name? The first citizen. I hate to leave a job only half done. That's a spirit. I was hoping you'd say that. Great. Just use this disk here on Vault City's Central Computer and then get it right back here. We'll use less uranium, the core won't leak so bad, and This Vault City won't have any reason to come exterminate us. I sure don't want to see Gecko destroyed. I'll do it. I sure wish I could spare the time to do it myself, but I can't. All I can say is thanks, kid. You'll be doing all of us here a big favor. Sniff, sniff. You make me so proud. Well, I better get going. Goodbye, Festus. I'll be back with the data you need just as soon as I can. Jeez. The ghouls. And they're the nicest ones out of anybody. Plenty of time to chat after we optimize the reactor. We're running good. We're cooking with gas, so to speak. That's me. Thanks for fixing the reactor. Alright. I got a lot of friggin' experience for that. Okay, so we got this optimization disk, reactor holodisk. The label on this holotape reads Gecko Reactor Performance Data. This disk contains a string of numbers that mean nothing to you. There sure is a lot of information here, and it must be important to someone somehow. Weighs 1 pound. Okay. Now I know I'm terrible. Who wanted this toolkit again? I think the man in the junkyard. Super repair kit for Skeeter. Optimize the power plant. Alright. Let's go to Skeeter then. And then I guess we'll call it an episode. I can't believe he actually did it. I thought he was BSing us. So yeah, this Fallout 2, I guess, surprises you sometimes. What you expect to happen isn't quite what will happen. Where is he again? In this big one, right? Yeah. Yeah, he's here. Hey there, you're back with my repair kit. Snap off. They're the best. Ready to trade? It's a deal. It's a mighty fine trade. You should be able to just plug that sucker in and get your car working. You know, I could do you another favor by fixing up some of your stuff for free, too. Really? That's actually my bona fide reaction. This is really... For free, huh? What do I need to do for you? Well, you see, I need a darn 3-step plasma transformer. And the only place I can figure to get one is from the supply room. Why don't you just get it from there, then? I kind of wore out my welcome there, and it was only a little fire, too. Could have happened to just anyone. Anyway, they won't let me anywhere inside the reactor building now. I need someone else to get my part for me. How do I get the plasma transformer for you? You gotta get yourself a supply requisition form. Once you have that, just give it to Jeremy in the supply room, and he'll give you any darn thing you want. You can get supply requisitions from Harold or Festus. Where are Harold and Festus, and will they just give me the form I need? Harold's in the settlement, and Festus is in the reactor control room, but you might have to kind of get the forms on the sly, if you know what I mean. You mean have to steal the requisition form, don't you? Well, yeah, I guess so. You might ask them, but I wouldn't put your chances too high there. I'll see what I can find out. So I gained 250 XP. Deliver the repair kit to Skeeter. Let's see. Well, if he'll do it for free. I could always give it to Vic, I guess, the Desert Eagle. Before I go stealing anything, let me go try talking to Harold. Harold's in here, right? I knew it had a sign on it like that.
Mighty kind of you, helping us out with the atomic power plant. We're in your debt. Now, what can this cranky old carcass do for you?
I don't even have an option to ask him about the requisition form.
Well, you might try talking to Woos over in the harp. What you need, youngster?
Youngster?
Well, we're doing better now you fixed our reactor. I never thought anybody get those idiots in Vault City to help us out.
I didn't want to see Vault City destroy your town.
Mighty kind of you. Not many smooth skins would do that for a town full of ghouls. Kinda reminds me of a smoothie I knew way back when.
Yeah. Another smoothie? What do you mean?
Another smooth skin. Had a lot of respect for that one.
Let me guess. The original Vault Dweller. Who's that?
Well, I could probably remember if I wasn't dead. I'd never get tired of that joke.
Maybe you don't?
Yeah, to be honest, can't remember the name. But they wore a funny suit, kinda like the one you're wearing.
I'm wearing the vault suit that my ancestor wore. It's a totem of my holy quest.
That's so. Well. That explains a thing or two. I wondered why you looked familiar. I'm not losing the last couple of marbles I got left.
Tell me what the vault dweller was like.
There is a resemblance, near as I can remember anyways. You know, your ancestor saved the whole darn lot of us.
I think I might have had this conversation. The Vault Dweller saved all the ghouls.
Jumping to conclusions, youngster. That's gonna get your ass shot off someday. All of us saved every two-legged shuffler on the dang planet.
I didn't realize that.
Well, now you do. And what happened next? For a thank you, the damn high and mighty Vaulties booted the Vault Dweller out. I always wondered what happened after that.
I can tell you what happened.
Well, I'd sure like to hear that.
Yeah, I don't remember saying all this. The legend of the Vault Dweller starts with the Vault casting her out into the dry wastes. You tell Harold the story of your ancestor. And so that's why I'm looking for Vault 13 now.
Well, thanks for telling. I sure was curious all these years. You've got your work cut out for you. You know...
Know what?
Well, I've been saving these for a rainy day, but it sounds like you're gonna need them more than I ever will. Here, take these.
What did I get? Thanks.
What you need, youngster?
I don't know what he gave us. Here's the fuel cell controller. From Skeeter. This chip controls the flow of power into a car's electric engines. Many drivers quickly burnt out this chip through frequent rapid acceleration. Still a valuable part to have if you only had the car to install it in. I do, though. Let's get back to... Not sure exactly where. Can find out, though. The den? Get a car part for Smitty. I'm right. So I have to get the GAC, get the car part to Smitty in the den. Klamath appears done. Vault City, some things. Now we need to get something else for Skeeter. Well, we're at the den. At some point, we'll find Woody the Ghoul. Fix the mine's air purifier. I think we have to build a little higher level. We need protective gear of some kind, which I haven't found yet. Find a way into the Sierra Army base. Yeah, I think that's a little higher level as well. Find the excavator chip. Oh yeah, I don't remember where to look for that. Find Sulik's missing sister. Alright. Oh, he's with us again, this guy. Oh, he is moving faster. Gonna have him wait here again. I don't know if it's gonna happen every time we leave Gecko, or we're done with them looking for us for now. Meaning, of course, the Enclave. We are not strong enough to be fighting them. Not for a while. So, gonna hold off on leveling up because who knows if we get out of it this time. Gonna try my best to get back to Vault City once again. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.